in Christ, the Lord Almighty. Again, we thank God for Usher Ministry number two. We thank God for all of our ministries here at the Asian Baptist Church. We're all important. We make up the body, with Christ being the head. And for those of you who are not involved in any ministry, there's something wrong with your religion. Amen. Because God has not saved you just to sit and be a member. You ought to be involved in some ministry in the church. At this time, Sister Rhonda Bush is going to come encourage us. Amen. On being an usher. Amen.
Giving up unto God, Pastor Thibodeau, Reverend King, Ministers Present, members of this great church, and all the visitors, welcome to the Age Baptist Church and good morning. First, let me say that I am honored that I was asked to bring words of encouragement on today. When I was asked, my first thought was, why do we always give words of encouragement? Sister Jackson did the same thing last night. However, I began to do my research on this topic. I Googled everything from Bible verses, quotes, definitions, famous things, just about anything I could think of that would give me some sort of idea of what I should say. I even reached out to my Christian friends for help, advice, and yes, encouragement. During this past week, I learned that without encouragement, people feel unloved. John chapter 13, verses 34 and 35 says, "Now I am giving you a new commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. You should love each other. Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples." We all know how difficult it can be to love. So encouragement makes it easier for us to love as Jesus loved us. I also learned that without encouragement, life would seem burdensome and pointless. Without encouragement, we become overwhelmed by the real pain of our lives. John chapter 10 and verse 10 says, "The thief's purpose is to steal, kill, and destroy. My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life." I can now answer the question that I once asked myself. Why do we always offer words of encouragement? We offer encouragement because encouragement nurtures patience and kindness. We offer encouragement because encouragement gives us hope. Encouragement helps us in tough times. Encouragement allows us to persevere when we are being tested. Encouragement gives us the will to carry on. Encouragement makes it easier to live in a fallen world in a holy way. Encouragement makes it easier to sacrifice one's own desires for the advancement of God's kingdom. In short, encouragement makes it easier to walk this Christian walk. So today, I not only want to encourage my fellow ministry sisters and brothers, I would like to encourage everyone here to continue to do the work that you do in the name of our Lord and Savior. Because 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 9 through 10 says, "So whether we are here in this body or away from this body, our goal is to please Him. For we must all stand before God to be judged. We will each receive whatever we deserve for the good or the evil we have done in this earthly life." In closing, I would like to share this. We only have one life. It soon will pass, and only what's done for Christ.
Thank you. There's power. There's power in the name of Jesus.
There's power in the name of Jesus.
Let's come this morning with a prayer. This morning, let us pray together.